We are back here at the RBC Center as the Canes and Penguins get together for the 106th time in NHL history. Take a look at the goaltenders tonight for Carolina. Their team defense is number 28. Cam Ward will start for the 11th consecutive game. Danny Sabourin did not play last night. Ty Conklin did. Pittsburgh's team defense is number 12. Sabourin has a great glove hand, and he's a big guy. We'll take a look at the officials tonight. The referees are Eric Furlock and Brad Watson, with Derek Amell and Brian Mock on the lines. And my partner, Trip Tracy, here on Valentine's Day, is stationed between the benches.
Well, as I said in Hurricanes Live, it is not just Valentine's Day. It's your birthday, John.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. All day. Thanks for reminding me as we progress in life.
Years ago,
turn the page.
Years ago, your parents weren't able to do something special on the Day of the Roses because you were being delivered. The great day that was 43 years ago.
All longer than that, Mr. Tracy. Don't start with that 43. A blizzard in Springfield, Massachusetts, way back when. 1962. Do the math. Here's Eric Staal over the line, walking in for a shot blocked by Sergei Gonchar. To the corner it goes. The big line is out for Michael Therrien with Malkin, Sikora, and Ryan Malone. The cruise missile is 71. Malkin in the middle. It's played at the defense by Nick Vallin. Carolina has been beset again by a flu virus. We'll catalog that. We did in Hurricanes Live. They're playing without some key players. Three players have been brought up. Defensemen from the Albany River Rats. Daryl Sador's shot tipped wide out in front that time. Looking for that redirect was Jarkko Ruutu. Now in the center zone, it's Roddy Brind'Amour. He'll clear it in for the Canes. Annie Sabourin moving it off from the corner now. The Penguins have it through the center zone. You see it go by Big George Larocque, and it's free for Frank Kaberle. He's paired with young Casey Bora. This is his second recall. Played eight games earlier this season. Kaberle with a shot over the top of Sabourin. The veteran Daryl Sador there for Pittsburgh. Andrew Ladd on the ice with his line mate Sergei Samsonov and Rod Brind'Amour. Ryan Whitney now gets it ahead for Larocque. Played off the boards. Stolen by Carolina's Brind'Amour and popped right back in Pittsburgh ice.
One of the benefits of being down here, Joe Boy, we'll get to that in a minute. Rod Brind'Amour is hurt with all the players out. Now Brind'Amour, some sort of lower body injury. He's grabbing his left knee. Oh, this is not good. Just when you think things can't get any worse.
Oh, boy.
The big thing will be, will Rod Brind'Amour come to this door right next to me in the bench or go to the locker room? It looks like he's coming here, which is an encouraging sign.
Collision with young Nathan Smith, 41, then a little nudge from Larocque. You'll see it again, Tripp.
Let's watch it coming up right here. It's a clean hit. He gets sandwiched. And that leg must have just gotten twisted. And now he's headed to the dressing room. This is not good.
Nope.
Because Rod Brind'Amour, we all know, if he's wincing in pain, there is some sort of pain that most of us probably couldn't tolerate.
And there's an obvious hush over the crowd with Brind'Amour going to the dressing room. We'll await word. Tim Conboy is one of those three brought up from Albany. He's wearing number 38 in the red tonight. Nick Vallin over the line, moving in. Off for Ryan Beta. His shot rolls in front, blocked by Chris Letang. Sabourin tries to locate it. He does. He'll melt it down for a faceoff in his own zone.
A good, hard-working shift here from the infused energy from Albany. Keith Acoin and Ryan Beta, along with Walker, they did a great job in the first period to set the tone against Boston. You can't help but feel for Peter Laviolette, as his team is going to probably surpass 300 man games lost. And just when you get home and you feel like you can control your own destiny in the division, I mean, these are rash injuries, and it's continuous.
Carolina 13-11-2 here. That's the 26th best record home ice wise in the NHL. That needs to improve as they play 15 of their last 23 at home. Pittsburgh is 15-10-2 on the road. The Pens are 6-2-2 in their last 10 away from the igloo. Jeff Hamilton moves it out to neutral ice. Ryan Whitney, a good-looking young defender, goes across for the veteran Daryl Sador, who gives it back. Peter Laviolette has a line combination of Jeff Hamilton, Trevor Letowski, and Wade Brookbank on the ice. Glenn Wesley being paired in this situation now and holding onto that puck with Nick Vallin as his defense partner. And those two players will play about 25 minutes plus tonight. It's cleared ahead now for Andrew Ladd over the line. He tries to set up a coin, who's taking the spot of Brind'Amour on this line with Samsonov and Ladd. They go to the corner. Whitney plays it along the board. Samsonov there for Carolina. Moving it back for Keith Acoin. Acoin for Samsonov. Ladd hooks it wide. What a combination play by Samsonov and Ladd. Ladd again for a shot that was nullified, but a penalty is being called. And we'll get a Carolina power play early.
Just a super shift from Samsonov and Ladd, and with Rod Brind'Amour in the dressing room. See the call being made. Keith Acoin gets a chance in the middle. Andrew Ladd just had a great shift. It began with a play right in front of me here at ice level in the neutral zone. And then three hardworking guys create a good chance. The best chance was a one-timer from Ladd in the slot, and he just didn't get all of it. But you do see Stahl in the box for tripping.
And right off the faceoff, they score. Carolina gets a power play goal as it came back to Ray Whitney. And the Canes are off and running.
Boy, is that ever just what the doctor ordered. You win a draw, and on a night like tonight, when your lineup is undermanned like it is, especially on the blue line, you need your best players to be your best players. It's just that true. And you've got traffic in front. Another angle will tell us that Eric Stahl says it's Ray Whitney's goal all the way. Let's make sure. Wow, that definitely hit something. It looks like Stahl's stick was in the vicinity, and then Cole was in the vicinity too, John.
Yeah.
And either way, you win a draw. You have traffic in front. You have Whitney with that right shot, ready to one-time that puck and take advantage of traffic.
If it is Ray Whitney, his first goal in 11 games. So he gets off the mark here with just 4 seconds elapsed on the penalty to Jordan Stahl. And Carolina gets a much-needed power play goal. The Hurricanes 0 for 18 in the last five with a man advantage coming in. The pass picked off by Whitney. His shot blocker down with a purpose by Danny Sabourin. They have given a goal to Eric Cole. Picks up a power play goal out in front on the redirect. Ray Whitney will get an assist on it. The primary helper as it's gloved by Danny Sabourin. No further play. Tonight's injuries and scratches, there are many, are brought to us by Rex Healthcare.
Well, let's hit on the big ones. For Pittsburgh, Sidney Crosby is on the road with the Penguins. He's in the building tonight. Skated for quite some time this morning. They will be patient with that ankle injury. Fleury played a game last night in the American Hockey League. Brind'Amour can be added to that list, that huge list for Carolina. Jeff Hamilton just asked me if I saw if it was knee on knee when I looked at the replay.
Back to the point now. Joey Mormina, a Montreal native out of Colgate University. This is his first NHL game. He'll play it along the boards. His third professional season. Playing two seasons with Manchester of the AHL, this year with Albany. Tim Convoy takes a run at Jeff Tate. Now it's brought in here by Chris Beach, who's floored by Mormina. Brooks Orpik steers it towards the goal. It's poked out. Acoin had it. He lost it. Beach after it now. 24 and white. Playing with his third NHL team this year. He's plucked off the waiver wire. A breakout for the Hurricanes. Keith Acoin feeds it in on Sabourin. He goes softly to the corner with it. Walker gets it from Beta. Options off for Acoin. Centered for Beta. Knocked down by Chris Letang. Chris Letang now with a backhand shovel that will jump all the way back in the Hurricane zone. Circling the net and reversing the flow. Casey Bohr. This is Frank Kaberle from his own zone. Right on the tape of Trevor Letowski. Letowski's in for a weak shot that's covered up by Danny Sabourin.
A good reverse between Bohr and Frank Kaberle playing their first game together here. And Michel Therrien, as I said, Hurricanes Live did not like his team's work ethic last night as they got down 2-0 to the Boston Bruins. And Carolina, even without so many players, has just come out here and outworked his hockey club so far tonight. Now he's using a goaltender in Sabourin that has played very well, including winning a game earlier this season in Pittsburgh against Carolina.
Eric Cole gets the goal for the Hurricanes, his 13th from number 13, Ray Whitney, and Jeff Hamilton at 3:13 on the power play. They clear it deep. Tim Convoy played a game in mid-January here against Colorado, his only NHL matchup. Now it's centered out in front. Brookbank had it. He lost it. Jarkko Ruutu is there for Pittsburgh. Ward wandering out to play it. Sealed off momentarily by Big LaRocque. He'll feed it deep. Convoy looking over his shoulder. Sidor pinches in for Pittsburgh. Nathan Smith off his skate, covered up by Cam Ward. And we'll see the goal trip one more time.
Well, a couple of things happen. Well, hang on here. There's going to be a fight here.
There is. Tim Convoy wants a piece of Nathan Smith, I believe. Yes, it is. Smith was the player that hit Brind'Amour. Convoy in his first NHL game had the opportunity to tangle with Scott Parker of Colorado early in the game.
Convoy knows exactly what his role is. Right in front of me here as I'm down between the benches, he drilled somebody stepping up at the right time not to put himself out of position. And now he comes out and he's willing to exude the toughness that every team is looking for. Let's take one more look at the goal. As Stahl's stick was right there, and then Eric Cole has that puck go off of him and into the net. But you just look back, you win a draw cleanly with the man advantage. Faceoffs are that much more important. And you have Hamilton that makes a good, deliberate, crisp pass to Ray Whitney in a position where he could one-time it and take advantage of those bodies in front of the net.
Penalties on the board. Convoy for Carolina, Smith for Pittsburgh on sportsmanlike conduct. 5:32, 4-on-4 we go. Carolina has scored once in this scenario, given up 5. Pittsburgh has scored 3 times, yielded 2. Problem with the score clock, and that's why one of the officials is at the scorer's table now. That's Eric Furlot, and he's adjusting the score clock. 14:28 left in this first period. John Forslund upstairs. Trip Tracy at ice level tonight here on FSN South. Eric Stahl will draw against Evgeny Malkin. Malkin is number 2 in NHL scoring, as he has vaulted himself from the 14th place position after Sidney Crosby went out with that ankle injury. Nick Pauline, the backhand wide of Sabourin. Eric Cole in this 4-on-4 scenario. Eric Stahl has it. No goals in 7. He's knocked down by Sergei Gonchar. Cole leaves it for Stahl along the boards. In the line of Eric Cole, along with Ray Whitney, were challenged today by Peter Laviolette for a big game. And so far, the Hurricanes, as you see in the shot chart, have come up big. Cole centering one out in front. It's knocked down and brought out here by Ryan Malone. Malkin, 2-on-2, drops it off for Malone. Poke check by Vallin. On the target, a good save by Cam Moore. Getting to it now is Nick Vallin, deep in his own zone. 70 seconds left on the 4-on-4.
I would expect that Stahl is going to play against Malkin strength on strength, especially with Brind'Amour now out, and Nick Vallin and Glenn Wesley will have the task of logging a lot of minutes, and they've been good in the first couple shifts against those three guys, namely Evgeny.
One in the zone by Whitney. Whitney holding onto it, stomping on a dime, feeding one intended for Borer. He wipes it across. It's poked wide right out in front. Andrew Ladd gets the inside track on Chris Letang, and Ladd doing all that lunch bucket work along the boards. Now it's popped out for Borer. Inside for Ladd again. Awaiting that pass now, using the boards, protecting the puck. He's punished by Orpik, who leads Pittsburgh in terms of hits. With it now is Ray Whitney. Whitney goes to work down low in the Pittsburgh zone, nullified again by Orpik. They continue that scrum. Whitney working hard, and Peter Sikora has the loose change.
Ladd has had a very good start in all areas to this hockey game, all over the ice. He's settling the puck, playing with composure. That's a sign of confidence. He's getting himself involved physically, and he's going to the net.
Frank Kaberle with steam shoots one. The Hurricanes are just a bit offside, and we get a stoppage. Eric Cole getting the Canes on the right track early here, finally at home at the RBC Center.
Thus far, Eric Cole has made Pittsburgh hurt where it counts, and the history dating back that actually now with what's happened, I would consider ancient. It was a very debatable hit from Brooks Orpik. Eric, of course, had a broken neck, came back for the last two games of the Stanley Cup Finals, but they fought a few weeks ago early in a hockey game. It was eerie. It was the same spot on the ice in Pittsburgh that hit occurred years ago, and now Cole, you need your best players to be your best players when you're dealing with a depleted lineup, and Carolina, a good start from that standpoint.
Sabourin freezes, another faceoff in the Pittsburgh zone. Tampa Bay is playing Philadelphia tonight. Southeast team in action, and Tampa Bay has an early 1-0 lead in the first period.
Smith and Convoy are still going at it here, so they may fight at some point. Now Smith will come off the ice.
Tim Convoy, captain material. He's become that for Tom Rowe at Albany. Over 180 minutes in penalties. A guy who's played about 250 AHL games before he had a chance to make his NHL debut in January. Playing his second game and making that impression. Peter Laviolette talked about him at practice yesterday and the opportunity to come up here and do exactly what he's trying to do. Stir the pot. Ryan Whitney at the target. Tipped wide right out in front. Tyler Kennedy tries to wheel it for Pittsburgh. The Canes have the answer. Here they come. Over the line, Sergei Samsonov putting a move on the D, and Whitney holding on to it. Ryan Whitney takes over off of Samsonov and frozen again. by Danny Saverin. Congratulations to Bob Langford of Raleigh, tonight's winner in the John Deere hat trick giveaway. Should a Kane score 3 goals tonight, he picks up a John Deere 105 lawn tractor. Go to johndeere.com/hattrickgiveaway for more details.
6-1 the engine shots for the Carolina Hurricanes. That might have been Pittsburgh's best chance here in the early going. Jordan Staal in front of the net, who all accounts say that next to Malkin, he has been Pittsburgh's best forward of late.
Sikora looking for Malkin. Malkin, Malone, and Sikora. Answered by Staal, Cole, and Whitney. It's the matchup Laviolette wants. Along the boards now, Sikora losing it. Malone has control, dragging on Wesley right in the face of Malone. It pops out. Malkin awaiting the pass, has it on a cycle now. Ryan Malone, whose dad played for Pittsburgh, 1976 through 83. It comes back for Gonchar. His shot wide of Cam Ward. With heavy-duty traffic out in front. Down low, Wesley after it, so is Vallin. Malkin is on him, and he's a load to handle for Nick Vallin as they battle along the boards. Ryan Malone is taken down, helping out Eric Staal. Malkin after it, Carolina being hemmed in. Gonchar at the point. He'll feed it deep. He took a hit from Cole. Vallin trying to freeze the puck there with Malone on him. Now it's centered by Sikora, mopped up by Whitney, and Carolina will survive.
Eric Cole delivering what Laviolette wants as Cole finishes a hit and then even goes in for more on Sergei Gonchar. They're going to have to stay on the ice here because Carolina is guilty of icing the puck. It'll be interesting to see if the Penguins try to get right out and get this puck dropped, but that's what Cole needs to do. Not only score, he needs to finish hits on the most skilled players on the opposition. Gonchar certainly is one of them.
I'm sure you can feel the intensity down there, Trek, and you must be jawing away at each other.
You can see it on Carolina's bench because they know each guy needs to be that much better when you're dealing with the roster you are. And that starts and ends with your best players.
One-timer by Tafe. It's blocked in front that time by Glenn Wesley. He'll skate across and go off in a change, and back to get it is Daryl Sador. 17, that is Rod Brind'Amour, will not return. That's the word we have. He's under evaluation. No other details have been furnished. So Rod Brind'Amour is done for the night and will not be back. Danny Saverin now lays it along the wing. Jeff Tafe for Pittsburgh. And that knee-to-knee collision, Nathan Smith, Rod Brind'Amour, in the early moments of this hockey game. Colby Armstrong beating one in back of the goal. He took a hit from Joey Mormina. Orpik this way, Ryan Whitney. His shot answered by Cam Ward. Getting to the rebound is Ryan Beta, and away go Carolina. You're looking at Scott Walker, a long bomb caught by Danny Saverin. He'll slow it down. 9:50 left to go in this first period. Eric Cole has the goal. The Canes have a 1-0 lead.
Eric Cole has given Carolina a 1-0 lead. Eric, I've noticed the real detail to finishing guys physically just recently on Gonchar. How important is that here against the Penguins?
Well, obviously, he's a key component of their defense core, and he's a patient guy. You know, he'll hold on to that puck and look you off, so you always got to be trying to, you know, finish through him at all times. Otherwise, he's going to make you look pretty silly.
Eric Cole on the subject of that man, Sergei Gonchar, who's having a remarkable season. Number two in terms of defense scoring behind Detroit's Nick Lidstrom. As the Penguins get control off the draw, they ice the puck. Caverta back on the touch. And we get a whistle. Let's take a look at the Rat Pack, Mr. Tracy. All these players, many of them brought up today.
Well, you and I said in our pregame show that we thought that Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr., Dean Martin would be in the lineup. And boy, they've done well so far. For the three defensemen, Convoy, Mormina, and Casey Moore, with travel, they didn't even get here until about 5:30. So this is a great start with the kind of intensity that Carolina has needed here with the reality of what the injuries are.
And we can't forget Joey Bishop, Peter Lawford in the Rat Pack. Maxime Talbot with a shot stopped by Cam Ward. Talbot has two shorthanded goals this season that leads Pittsburgh. They battle along the boards. Tyler Kennedy, 48, Jordan Staal, and Maxime Talbot. Staal working a cycle here, but he's defended by the combination of Caverla and Ladd. Whitney rolling it in for Staal. His shot blocker down by Cam Ward with a sharp save. And it comes out for Sergei Samsonov.
That began with a tough pitch from Casey Bohr and Talbot. And he just slammed the door getting off the ice next to me, frustrated, because that was a great A chance on that 2-on-1.
Vallin back out to center. Tyler Kennedy, who's had a bout of mononucleosis this season, fed it ahead. Vallin across for Wesley. Wesley now along the boards is hit by Ryan Malone. Getting to it here is Gonchar. Malkin. The center zone, dropping it back for Sikora. His pocket pick by Ray Whitney, who helped out on the first goal. A redirect by Eric Cole. That point shot taken by Ray Whitney. The Wizard, tough angle. Severin the save, and he takes care of the rebound. With Eric Staal right out in front. Wesley down deep. It goes by Staal. Look to track it down at the top of your screen. He finishes off Gonchar. And it comes all the way back in Kane's ice. Nick Vallin now deep in his own territory. Will bank it off the boards. Chipped ahead by Eric Cole. He'll go off on a change. Severin. Close play there right along the line of the trapezoid. He feeds it off to the D, and now it's brought out here by Nathan Smith. Smith over the line. The Penguins are offside.
Conboy and Smith almost went at it again there. Looks like cooler heads will prevail. Geico will bring us a quick chalk talk here. And Carolina wants to make sure they have a third man eye if you're going to pitch right here. You don't. Look at all three forwards caught deep. So you want to back off if you're Bohr. And it creates a two-on-one up the ice. And Talbot elects to shoot. Therrien looking for scoring other than just the Malkin line. And Cam Ward makes a big early save.
Joffrey Lupul has just scored for Philadelphia, 1-1 with Tampa Bay, and now we have the altercation, a heavyweight matchup between George LaRocque of Pittsburgh and Wade Brookbank of Carolina. Some shadow boxing here at the outset, right hand by Brookbank, LaRocque with a couple of lefts, Brookbank losing his edge, going down, a headlock on LaRocque, and the whistle blows as the linesmen move in.
Both such honest fighters. It's really fun to watch when you see two guys that know what the rules are, know what their roles are. And at times, LaRocque has been mic'd up during these fights, and he'll tell a guy right afterwards, good job. I was watching a game Saturday afternoon that they just played against the Los Angeles Kings, and it showed one of his past fights where before the faceoff dropped, he said, okay, we're going to go, aren't we? Hey, listen, I wish you the best of luck in this fight. I mean, they just know what their purpose is. And it's essentially the truth that they'll fight, then who knows, go for a beer after the game. I mean, that's just the way that these old school guys think about things. And Brookbank, good for him. He did tell me when we were just in Pittsburgh, he had not fought George LaRocque in his career. So that's his first altercation with George LaRocque.
Tim Conboy for Carolina plays it along the boards. Getting back to it is Ryan Beta, Frank Caverla, Conboy again. Was by Keith Acoin, Beta, Acoin, and Conboy in the ice. Three who played most of the year with Albany. Now it's Ruutu. Dropping it off for Nathan Smith. He'll pull up, shoot one, and it rolls deep. Conboy defending Ruutu. Rolls out for Ryan Beta. Beta is away out to center ice. Partial 3-on-2 for Carolina. Ryan Beta coming up on the D. Severin out to play it. Along the wall, cut off by Acoin. Levitating that puck over the top of Scott Walker. They get to it, and now it's brought out here by Colby Armstrong. Armstrong going wide of Nick Vallin. Vallin with a little pin on Armstrong. Out of the corner now, it's left there on a cycle by Ruutu. Armstrong again, wedged by Orpik. They score! Through a screen in front. Brooks Orpik let it go from the point, and the Penguins have tied it.
Well, that's just a goal you can't give up. That's a goal you can't give up. He's public enemy number one here, but you have to compliment Brooks Orpik for cheating in there from the point. He's way in. This is going to give us a good look. Instead of hanging out at the point, look how far he slides in here. And this doesn't hit anything. Cam Ward's deep. That stick is to the side, not square in front of him in that butterfly position. And with all the circumstances here, there's just no way of getting around the fact that you need that save. You just need it. Yeah, but nonetheless, it's a really good job from Orpik from being active and jumping in, getting it off quickly, and at least forcing the goaltender to be accountable. And that's a shame for Carolina, and hopefully that will not take a lot of wind out of this bench.
This is game number 56 for Brooks Orpik and his first goal of the season, which has tied the game at one. Jordan Staal now for the Pens, a long pass intended for Tyler Kennedy. Now it's knocked down again. Kennedy centers one. The stick lifted. That's Max Talbot's stick lifted by Tim Conboy. The Penguins will circle back. 6:32 left to go in period one. As we're deadlocked at one, Chris Letang for the goal scorer. Brooks Orpik on the wing now. It's Talbot. Off the board. Stolen by Carolina's Casey Bohr. And he'll dump it in. And Severin now puts it on a tee for Chris Letang. Played in the Young Stars game during the All-Star competition. in Atlanta.
If Max Talbot slams this door right next to me one more time, he's going to take it off of his hinges.
Maybe it's you.
Maybe it is. He doesn't like my tie.
You showered today. Whitney with a shot, fended off by Sabrin.
How do you know?
I'm assuming you did. Good point. I don't want to know. Whitney now holding on to it. Here's Kaberla. His shot stopped by Sabrin. Heading to it is Kaberla again. Whitney looking for Stahl. Knocked down by Sikora. Ray Whitney strong along the wall. Inside for Big Eric Stahl. Stahl goes to work holding on to it. In the slot, Kaberla is denied, and it's brought out by Ryan Malone. He pitches it by Eric Cole. He walks in for a shot. Cam Ward says no. And the net is off the peg. Sikora in a collision. The officials don't see it. And finally, they whistle it dead. 5:26 left to go in this first period. Brooks Orpik, who's born in San Francisco, gets the goal for Pittsburgh. It's time for a 10th anniversary moment, and we take you back to October 7, 2005, second game of the season, and the first win for goaltender Cam Ward in a shootout, Sidney Crosby's rookie season. Mario Lemieux still playing. Ward says no on that bid. And the other player involved in that was Ziggy Palfy. It was a tremendous game, an uplifting experience for everyone in the house that night. And Cam Ward getting it done, his first win.
Brad Watson was just talking, Watson the official, talking to LaViolette about Terry and maybe getting a little loose with him having to put his guys on the ice first on the road, John.
Okay, we'll keep an eye on it. Now it's Gonchar ahead. Tripp can see all of that, hear all of that. He is stationed between the benches tonight. As we do on occasion here at the RBC Center, first of two at home for Carolina. They're home here against the Florida Panthers Saturday. No local television. Walker's shot answered by Danny Sabrin. Fed in back of the goal. Swing and a miss by a coin. He's nullified by Rob Scuderi. Now playing it here along the wall is Ryan Beta. A coin in deep for Walker. Walker holding onto it. Gonchar flushes him out. Walker centers one, and it's wedged wide by Beta. What a chance. Ryan Beta right out in front. A coin covering up at the point. This line was good in Boston, and they're having a good start here. That's a coin, Walker and Beta. Colby Armstrong tries to move it by Glenn Wesley. Sergei Gonchar will steer it in for Pittsburgh.
That door just got slammed again.
I heard it.
What a good, hard-working shift. That'll frustrate you if you're Pittsburgh and the door is feeling the brunt of it.
Sabrin hanging on to the shot taken by Andrew Ladd. What a chance for young Ryan Bailey.
It's a great chance. This energy and work ethic. Look at Wesley cheating it. Good for him. Wesley might see some power play time. He hasn't really seen that with regularity since he broke in with Ray Bourque and the Boston Bruins. And this was nearly 2-1 for Carolina. Sabrin was behind the eight ball because he tried to get the centering attempt with his stick and couldn't.
Shots are 13-6 Carolina. They had the first six shots on goal in this game. They are playing without their captain, Rod Brind'Amour. It appears to be a knee injury. No details have been given other than the fact he will not be back tonight. You can sign up through the 21st to win $10,000, a personalized Canes jersey, a pair of benchside tickets, an intermission ride on the Olympia, and an opportunity to attend a Hurricanes practice. Register at all local participating Subway restaurants for this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Scott Walker just asked if the goaltender Sabrin got a piece of that Beta shot. So, and Scott knows that he's getting some real hard work from his line mates here. Namely, Beta there.
Wesley punches it back out to neutral ice. Shot in by Ryan Whitney. Wesley paired with Nick Vallin. Eric Stahl, Eric Cole, Ray Whitney on the ice. Wesley in back of the goal. The big line is out for Pittsburgh. Malkin's group with Sikora and Malone, the bookends. Defended at the line by Gonchar. Rob Scuderi is after it. It goes high in the air. And it's in the Pittsburgh bench, and now we see that log jam in the southeast.
It's just scary when you look at last night when you have three-point games. Washington and Atlanta. Atlanta wins in a shootout, but thanks to Alex Ovechkin and a late goal, both teams come away with points. Florida loses in overtime to Montreal, but they still get a point. And I think you mentioned earlier the Tampa that's trying to climb back in, that they maybe had gone up on the Philadelphia Flyers, and we'll have to see about what happens with Rod Brind'Amour, and we'll have to watch what happens in faceoffs in particular in the rest of this game.
The Canes have 13 divisional games left, 8 at home and 5 on the road. You can dictate their own destiny. It rolls in on Sabrin. He'll hang on again. 3:02 left to go in this opening period.
Scott Walker, as I mentioned, he and I just had a brief conversation. One of the benefits of being down here, this is how tough this guy is. Either from a hit or a hit that he actually delivered on Quinton Lane of Washington, or a fight on that same shift with Matt Bradley, Scott is having trouble hearing out of one of his ears.
Yeah.
He's still playing. He's got a myriad of other injuries that you'll never hear about. And it just goes to show the physical nature of playing this game, and we're just a ways away from that march that any team has to go to try to win a Stanley Cup. And then you can write novels about what players go through behind the scenes to try to stay healthy.
And that torn cartilage situation was as painful as it gets earlier this season against Pittsburgh. Put Scotty Walker out for a long time. He did not practice yesterday because of that ear problem. Carolina playing without Tim Gleason. Brett Hedekin in the back end. Joe Corvo. Ruutu with a shot off net, caught by Cam Ward, and no further play.
Well, while I'm down here, our fine statistician to your left, John, Brian Tatum, is cataloging the scoring chances. Carolina, I think, has given up one chance. For me, it was the two-on-one from Talbot. The goal, to me, wasn't even a scoring chance. So they have to be happy with what they've done in just about 17 and a half minutes of this first period. Because the better chances have been reflected in the 14-6 edge and shots for the Hurricanes.
And if you're just joining us, Rod Brind'Amour went down with an apparent knee injury early in this hockey game and will not be back tonight as he is under evaluation. A battle along the board. It pops out for Malkin. Malkin holding onto it, tries to walk out in front. Good play by Vallin. And now from the corner, it's Cole, stolen by Malkin. Malkin goes to work. All the way to the point, a sharp pass for Gonchar. One-timer Gonchar. As he set up Malkin, it was blocked by Wesley, and it's cleared back out to center ice.
Wesley said in our bench interview, didn't he, with Malkin, take away his time and space.
And he did on Malkin that time. Here's Malone dragging, moving on Bohr. Ryan Malone defended well by young Casey Bohr. And now a penalty, though, is being called down deep, this time by Brad Watson for the use of a stick. A hooking call is being made with 1:54 left to go in the first period.
Whitney doesn't like it. He's talking to Watson about it right now. Let's look for 13 in red as the big line for Pittsburgh tries to go to work. Where it is? There it is right there. Boy, I don't see anything of late. And you see that the penalty had already been called. This was a Pittsburgh power play that really let them down last night. They got a late power play goal, but when the game really mattered, they just couldn't get going. But it's been very good. They're going to start with their second unit.
A hooking call made on Ray Whitney at 18:06. Pittsburgh goes to work on the power play. That second unit is Jordan Staal, Jeff Tafe, Chris Beach, who did not play last night. He was a healthy scratch. Daryl Sador and Chris Letang on the points. Through the center zone, taken care of by Caberla. Shot ahead by Scott Walker as the Canes get it out. Pittsburgh is number 4 overall on the power play, 10th best on the road. Carolina 30th, both overall and at home on the kill. From the corner now, rolled back to the point for Chris Letang. Backhand saucer pass that finds Chris Beach. Inside it goes by Jordan Staal. Vallin is after it. Staal controlling. Beach now along the wall. Chris Beach asserts from the wall, holding onto it. Staal looking in the slot. He's guarded up top by Letowski. Letang faking a shot. Staal with a lane. His shot went right in front of it off Jeff Tafe. And then he was hit by Nick Vallin as Letowski tries to clear. Getting to it is Scott Walker. 52 seconds left to go in the period. You see the time left on the Pittsburgh power play.
That's a really good job in front by Carolina. And now the first unit with Malkin, Malone, and Sikora is just getting on for some power play time.
Malkin after it. Staal. Eric Staal for Carolina. Now it's Ryan Malone for Pittsburgh. He's checked by Wesley. Dug out by Malkin off the skates of Cole, who pummels Malkin in back of the net. Now loose along the boards. It kicks out. Into it here and going after it. Peter Sikora. Ryan Whitney loads the gun. It's blocked in front of it off Malone. As Wesley and Bohr are on the ice. This way it's Evgeny Malkin. 14 seconds left to go in the period. Tic-tac-toe passing now, but they can't break the box. Malkin again holding on to it. His shot blocked in front by Wesley. Moving up Gonchar. Getting to it Malone. Malone holding on to it. 2 seconds left in the period. Here's Gonchar. One final chance after the horn. And we have a 1-1 tie after 20. So Cam Ward looked at only 6 shots in the period. Brooks Orpik getting the goal for Pittsburgh. Carolina put everything at Danny Sabourin. 14 shots in that period. And Tripp is standing by at the bench with Scott Walker.
Thanks, John. Scott, with the guys out of the lineup, you have to be happy with that effort there in the opening 20 minutes.
Absolutely. You know, we can't make excuses. Everybody's here for a reason, and just got to work hard and bring everything we got tonight.
One of the advantages of being down here is even killing a penalty. You just finished a hit right here on Daryl Sador. Why is it so important to make sure you bring that physical edge when you're shorthanded as well as other situations in the game?
Well, you see early on in the shift, the guy takes a run at us when we're killing the penalty. So sometimes you relax a little bit when you're power play, so you want to get it right back. In front of your bench is always a good place. Gets the boys a little fired up. But we got to answer them hit for hit, and we got to be solid here.
I want to ask you one other thing. When you have guys like Beta, he's playing with you, bring up that infused energy from Albany, how much of a good impact does that have with the real impact players? I mean, your work ethic is there night in, night out, but that energy seems to help the entire bench.
Well, you know, it's like I talked to the coaches. They asked me, you know, how I felt playing with those two guys, Keith Acoin and Bates. I said, I love it. You know, as long as they're going to work hard and play me with anybody, that work ethic, I love it. You can feed off it. Helps me out. Gets me going. And I think it feeds through the lineup to see guys just dying to be here and dying to be out there.
That's one of the things that makes you a team guy. Maybe you want to get involved in this game. Scott, good luck in the second and third.
Looks like Char out here.
Back to you, John.
That's priceless. He would. Scotty Walker. As Tripp said, a great team guy. Eric Cole with a tip-in goal, and then Brooks Orpik from a soft spot on the ice tied it for Pittsburgh. The RBC Centura, first intermission after you watch this. The two goal scorers tonight here in Raleigh in a 1-1 standoff between the Penguins and the Hurricanes. Brooks Orpik and Eric Cole. Chevrolet has the numbers after 20.
A really good effort from the Carolina Hurricanes. Very, very solid. They get a power play goal. They'll be shorthanded, Will, Carolina, for the first 6 seconds here. And Pittsburgh's going to look to wake up. Sergei Gonchar, who's on the ice to start the period, just right next to me, used one of those smelling salts. And I said, can I get a little stick? So the Penguins will look to wake up, and Carolina will be tested to continue what was a very solid intensity level there in the opening period, John.
Ray Whitney has 6 seconds on his penalty. He went off for hooking at 18:06 of the first period. Rod Brind'Amour is out with a knee injury, will not be back. Carolina already playing tonight without three regulars on defense, Joe Corvo, Brett Hedekin, and Tim Gleason. Gleason and Corvo both have the flu, and Hedekin is out with a lower body concern as it comes all the way back in the zone, and there to play it is Sergei Gonchar. Rob Scuderi to the center ice area off the stick of Evgeny Malkin. Eric Staal to center ice, detected by Ryan Malone. Malone walks in, shoots one, Cam Ward answers, a big rebound. Sikora's shot is blocked on the way through. Malkin tracks it down. Evgeny Malkin's pass pinballs off Eric Cole and comes all the way down to Danny Sabourin.
Smart shot from Malone. He didn't have anybody with him, so put it in a position where if the goalie makes the save, your line mate might get to it, and Sikora was just a bit late.
At the line, Tyler Kennedy for Ryan Malone, who's offside. Just 49 seconds gone in the second period. Stop by any participating area Dunkin' Donuts store between now and the 29th. And register. 5 lucky fans and a guest will be treated to coffee with Coach Peter Laviolette, a pregame skate, 2 tickets to see the Canes take on the Minnesota Wild on March 6th. It's brought to you by Dunkin' Donuts. America runs on Dunkin'.
I could use a hot cup of that Java right now from Dunkin' Donuts because it's freezing down here. Thank God on nights like this I have an Austin Powers type rug.
It is frigid in this building. Brian Whitney through the center ice area, off the skates of Tyler Kennedy. New ice surface. The circus has been in town, and they take out the ice for that. So the ice crew in the last couple of days putting a new sheet down. No one skated on it last night, so the clubs did this morning, and that's it. Jordan Staal holding onto it. Off the stick of Kamerla, off the back of the goal. Talbot going down. He's punished a bit. Swung on the target by Kennedy. Good save by Cam Ward. Out of the corner now. Tyler Kennedy for Pittsburgh. Jordan Staal's shot is stopped by Ward. Out of the corner again. Pittsburgh has it. Jordan Staal's bit blocked by Casey Bourque. And now a penalty is being called. Carolina will be going down a man on this cycle sequence, and a good one by Pittsburgh.
And to my right, immediately Gonchar gets on the ice, and that signals one thing. They need the quarterback of the power play on, so this is going to be a great chance for the Penguins on fresh ice here. With even out Crosby, a very lethal power play. And with Brind'Amour already gone, Letowski is a guy that would have been called upon to kill the penalty, so that's like a double whammy. Let's watch it here and see if we can see where Letowski was gated for hooking. It was a good forechecking shift. Letowski from Thunder Bay, another Thunder Bay guy, Jordan Stahl. There he draws it, so one Thunder Bay guy on another. It's Letowski's stick that is guilty of hooking.
It wasn't much, but if it was on the hands and we couldn't tell from there, then it's an automatic. So Letowski gone for hooking at 143. Where the official was, he had a better view than we did on the replay. It's knocked down here by Eric Cole. Two on one with Stahl. Here they come. Cole holding on to it. Shooting one. Severin the save, and he kicks out a big rebound. The Penguins now turn it back. You're looking at Sergei Gonchar. Gonchar over the line. All the way across. Sakura's shot stopped by Ward. Getting to it, Ryan Whitney. Hooked along here by Eric Stahl. Shorthanded. Here he comes. Stahl holding. Shooting one. Severin says no twice on Eric Stahl. Carolina looking for their third shorthanded goal this season. They've scored one at home. Malkin for Malone. Back for Evgeny Malkin. The point man, Sergei Gonchar. He'll move it inside for Malkin on the target. Tipped in by Ryan Malone. Right out in front. Power play goal. The Penguins lead it by one.
Danny Severin has just made two huge saves. And actually, Malone, John, just pointed to Malkin saying that it went off of a Carolina player. The replay will tell the story. Either way, the most end-to-end hockey that we've seen in this hockey game, without question. Two huge shorthanded saves. Here's Malone in front. Now Malkin is going to throw it to the net. No,
it did.
Yeah, it does.
It did.
But
not Kaberle.
You have to look at it like this, though. If Malone doesn't go to the front of the net, which he does very well on power plays, then Frank Kaberle is not there, so his stick is not in a position to have that redirection occur. But circle that especially big save on Eric Cole on that two-on-one as Gonchar was caught. And Cole did a great job of improving his shooting angle, and Severin had a big save.
Evgeny Malkin will score for the 33rd time this season if they give him the goal. A guy who has been absolutely ablazing for Pittsburgh with now 22 goals in his last 25 games. Holding onto it now, Keith Lecoin for Scott Walker. Andrew Ladd awaiting the pass. Ladd is pinned by Chris Beach. Walker now holding onto it, trading places with Kaberle. Kaberle off the skates of Beach, getting it back. Frank Kaberle all the way across, punched on the target, off the goalpost. Great chance that time, and moving up was Joey Mormina. Looking for his first NHL goal in his first game. Out of the corner, it's Letang. Now Mormina at the point, brought up today from Albany. He'll play it in neutral ice. He's a big guy at 6'6".
Tom Rowe said he was playing the best of these defensemen called up, John, and he did everything right there but score. Had the goalie beat just off the post.
In the center ice area, Letowski. He'll flip it ahead. A spindling puck there to play at Orpik. Moved off at the line. Stolen here by Carolina's Sergei Samsonov. Brought in the zone by Jeff Tape. Tape cutting. He's floored by Mormina, who came all the way across. Transition time for Carolina. Letowski back for Samsonov. Samsonov cutting, holding onto the puck, turning for a shot. Severin the save. What a move by Sergei Samsonov. And Pittsburgh will survive.
Larocque just came over and said something to Mormina. George Larocque standing up did not like that hit. What a shift for Joey Mormina.
Samsonov feeds it in. He's canceled a bit by Ruutu. Severin. Ryan Whitney. Samsonov there too. Letowski back on the ice. After the power play goal was scored, we believe, by Evgeny Malkin. At the line now, it's Beta out to center ice. Now it's poked ahead. A good sweep check by Ruutu on Stahl. Stahl laid off the boards. Nathan Smith for Pittsburgh inside for Larocque. Larocque holding again. Moving it off in the flank for Ruutu. Cut off. The back checking of Whitney. That's Ray Whitney for Carolina. And it comes out to neutral ice. 2:37, the time of the goal. Malkin is 33rd unassisted on the power play. Whitney moved off for Stahl, turning his shot. Pinballs wide of Danny Severin. Just about 5 minutes gone in the second period. And a penalty is called. Eric Cole was knocked down by Rob Scuderi. And Carolina will get a power play.
They'll look to go 2-for-2 on the power play. We'll take a look at Mormina. For a big guy, he does a good job of keeping his arm in. By the way, John, right in front of me, Brad Watson is incensed with the Pittsburgh bench. Now he's coming over to the Carolina bench. He's talking about line changes, and when he puts his arm up, that you know, that's it. Don't try to tinker with any other changes. Joe Mormina, he's in a tough shooting position. It would have been easier if he was a right shot, and he still does it perfectly. A guy that went to Colgate, And that was just a shift of beauty. And you know you've done good things when LaRocque skates over and says something to you. That means that you're getting physical, you're using your size, and then creeping in nearly to tie this game.
George LaRocque peering down at that Carolina bench. Chris Letang, one of four penalty killers for Michael Therrien. Ryan Malone, Jordan Staal, Letang and Gonchar on the ice. Carolina has Staal, Eric Cole, along with Ray Whitney, Jeff Hamilton, and Frank Kaberle on the ice as they clear it in. Sabourin in the trapezoid on the wing for Jordan Staal. Staal through the center ice area. Ryan Malone in full flight going wide. Moving on the D of Kaberle. Paddle down for Cam Ward. Moved out here by Eric Cole. On the power play, they gain entry. Cole along the boards, back for Hamilton. Top of the umbrella, Frank Kaberle. Moved off on the wing for Ray Whitney. Whitney with a shot through traffic with the flex wide. Getting to it, Hamilton once again. He'll move it along the kick plate for Whitney. Whitney now will set up shot diagonally across for Hamilton. One time in the zone, deep for Staal. And right back for Hamilton. Kaberle looks it over. Malone defending. Whitney from the corner, flushed out by Letang. Kaberle again. Whitney cradling that puck. One-timer, Kaberle broke his stick in two. Loose puck in front, Gonchar is there. Whitney tries to win a battle from Staal, and he does. Now it's played by Wesley on the power play. Wesley for Hamilton. Whitney holding onto it. Wesley awaiting that puck down. Wesley looking it over in the skates of Whitney. Whitney gets it back. Wesley pummels one, and it goes off of Sabourin, who bats it high in the air. Hamilton tries to center one out in front. And it's loose, it kicks back for Wesley. Wesley faking a shot. Staal a one-timer. Oh, it's tipped wide by Cole. Getting to it, Jordan Staal. High in the air it goes. 22 seconds on the power play. Hamilton for Wesley. Now it's Staal again. His shot goes high. Big rebound out in front. Ryan Malone for Pittsburgh off the boards and up.
Len Wesley, how about it, John? Back to the Bruins days. That was a super-looking shooting power play. That was the key, a shooting power play.
Go back to the late 80s for that stuff. Now it's cleared ahead. It's Borg. Rolling it in deep to the corner now. Staal holding onto it. As the penalized man, Scuderi, is back on the ice for Pittsburgh. It's cleared all the way back. This will be icing as the Canes are back to fight. 12:48 left to go in the second period. The old Warrior on the power play. Looking good. 2-1. Pittsburgh.
After the Canes mounted a great power play attack and Eric Staal was a big part of it, Eric will now be in the box for the next two or less in the Pittsburgh end. Let's watch it here. Gonchar with his one-on-one ability. Yeah, that's a hook. Gonchar did get away maybe with a slight use of the free hand to gain this position. Yeah, he did right there. Good look from our truck. So it, as is often detected, the first one goes undetected. The second one is called. And boy, that Wesley's now going to kill a penalty, so he's seeing every special team situation here. John, he looked great on the power play there.
12:43 left to go in the second period. Staal for hooking at 7-12. Now it's cleared ahead by Sergei Gonchar. Deep in the zone. Eric Cole broken up here. Goes by Malkin. Malkin, Malone, and Sikora for Michael Therrien. They have Ryan Whitney and Sergei Gonchar in the back end. Carolina now replacing Eric Cole. He's replaced by Trevor Letowski. Ray Whitney also up front with Wesley and Vallin back. Wiped in by Gonchar, handled by Cam Ward. Ward plays it off the glass. Whitney looking for it, located by Ryan Malone. Malkin back to the point for Gonchar. Sergei Gonchar, now it's big Evgeny Malkin. Malkin loading the gun, and it goes wide of Cam Ward, and that was a screecher. Ryan Whitney in deep for Peter Sikora. Malkin centers one for Malone. Good defense by Nick Vallin, and it's dumped out by Trevor Letowski.
Super, super positioning from Vallin.
Malkin tries to put on a show. No quarter given by the Swede, and the secret weapon dumps it out. 52 seconds left, as you see, on this Pittsburgh power play. Pittsburgh going to work for the third time tonight in the power play. Kaberle, Casey Borre. The young man who played his college hockey at St. Cloud State clears it all the way back. 38 seconds left on the penalty to Eric Staal. 11:20 left in the second period. John and Troop with you here on FSN South Trip, stationed between the benches tonight. It's out in the slot. Walker had it. He lost it. Here's Chris Letang. On the wing now for Jordan Staal, who fumbles it. Fought off by Walker, and he kills time.
He drew a penalty, too.
Yes, he did. Slow to get up. They will check out his status. A high stick. They checked the chicklets there, and everything seems to be okay.
He's already missing a couple.
You wonder how the referee would know, right?
It don't. Yeah, that's one of those things where if you're Walker, the tough guy that he is, you're just hoping, bleed.
That's right.
But there's no doubt about the fact that Carolina's had the better-looking power play here in this hockey game. That last power play, like I said at the time, it was a shooting power play. When you look at, say, Montreal, that's what Guy Carbonneau wants. That's what he's got to have, as good of a power play as there is in the league. Have that shot. Once you establish that shot, everything else takes care of itself. And Carolina will get another chance at it with 16 seconds to go in this 4-on-4.
And on a serious note, they look for blood in that situation. None there. So Staal gets a penalty. Jordan Staal for high-sticking a two-minute minor. His brother's out of the box in 10 seconds. Carolina will have a power play. Here's a coin. Shot taken. Severin. Well, he gave up a rebound, and out in front that time was Andrew Ladd. The point man, Nicholas Vallin, his shot. He got underneath at a loose puck, as we see. As Staal is on the ice, Eric Staal, it's a power play for the Hurricanes. A coin turning away from the field, back for Vallin. Vallin on the power play. A coin holding onto it. Down low, it's Eric Staal. Staal holding onto the puck now, a coin. A coin in back of the goal, moved off for Caverla. Coming across is Nick Vallin. Vallin rifles one deep for Staal. Eric Staal on Rob Scuderi. From the flank, it's Whitney. Back to the point for Caverla. The Wizard, Ray Whitney, holding onto it down deep. Eric Staal across, it goes. Knocked down at the defense, right out in front, Gonchar. And it's cleared by the Penguins all the way down to Cam Ward. And the whistle blows again. Matching penalties being called with a 1:07 left and the penalty to Jordan Staal.
Going to be Cole and Gonchar. They've been going at each other all night. To see if Wesley comes on here and look at some of his work this morning. He's not used to playing the point of the power play. And as Glenn always will do in all facets, he's just going to keep the game simple. Anytime you talk to Glenn, if you had a dime for every time he uses the word simple, you'd be able to retire. And he kept his time in the power play very simple and simultaneously very effective, working very well on the top of the point with Eric Staal.
Glenn Wesley, you saw him getting the workout on the power play this morning. There was a time when Glenn Wesley was a focal point of the Boston Bruins power play in 1994. He had 44 assists, 58 scoring points that season. Raymond Bork. As the penalties are assessed to Sergei Gonchar, he gets the gate here along with Eric Cole, cross-checking at 9:50. Whitney moved off for Eric Staal. Staal holding onto it. Carolina maintains control. A half minute left in this power play. As the coincidental miners are wiped out, it's played along the boards by Ray Whitney. He'll tee it up through traffic. Severin the save. They score! Eric Staal gets the rebound, and the Hurricanes have tied it.
Well, that is just good-looking stuff. Good-looking stuff of getting the puck to the front of the net with all sorts of bodies, guys paying the price, and that was an all-star type play for a guy who gets his first goal since being the MVP in the all-star game. So that could open up the floodgates for Eric Staal. Whitney set up the first goal by getting a puck through. Look at that price that Andrew Ladd pays in front of the net. And look at the fact that Eric Staal drags this puck on the rebound to be able to beat the outstretched leg of Severin. And you can see the excitement. So two guys that need to score that haven't scored with regularity have done so. The two Erics, Cole in the first, now Staal in the second. And the power play has looked super for Carolina, now has converted twice.
28th goal of the season for Eric Staal. His eighth goal against Pittsburgh now in 13 games lifetime. Ray Whitney, Frank Caverla get the assist at 10:36. Power play goal. Caverla and Whitney setting up Staal. Carolina with two power play goals tonight, two out of three. 9:05 left to go in the second period. Deuce is wild here at the RBC Center. Rob Scuderi, he'll clear it ahead. Vallin defending his man. Attacking forward out, that was Peter Sikora. Malkin with a shot, it's tipped right on, and a good reaction by Cam Ward. Wesley had the block out in front. Carolina ices the puck. Orpik is back on it, and we get a stoppage. Eric Staal igniting the crowd here at the RBC Center, a night where the Carolina Hurricanes dig for character.
Well, we're back here. The power play is converted for the second time. John, it's looked very, very sharp. What have you liked most about the man advantage in this game?
I think the key to our success is the guys are just getting the puck to the front. And anytime you're able to do that, you can create some commotion and, you know, rebounds and different chances. So sometimes it's not pretty, but it's definitely getting the job done.
Well, we have a budding analyst in the waiting with John Graham. Excellent analysis.
John Forslund just said you're a budding analyst. I just relayed that information. Yeah, commotion, good word.
Excellent. I mean,
he's smiling.
That's good stuff. We thank John Graham, who always complies with us down there. Appreciate it. Now at the line, it's Malkin. Broken up here, Beta going all the way across. Now it's played along the boards by Eric Staal, getting to it. Evgeny Malkin back out to center ice. We're deadlocked at two. It's a good one tonight. The Hurricanes, with a depleted lineup, are hanging in there against the Pittsburgh team that's fought through a lot of adversity, too, with their top guy out, Sidney Crosby. Other injuries. They've utilized 13 players from their minor league team. Staal with a wrap chance. What a stop by Savarin. A quick whistle. Scott Walker looking for the loose puck. Eric Staal came flying in the zone and almost made it happen.
In the words of John Graham, there was some commotion here. And, boy, that puck nearly scooched through. And Carolina, with the guys out, is not just hanging in there. They have the control in this hockey game. You wondered if Pittsburgh would establish it after the first period. No, that has continued.
Tim Conboy with a spinner blocked by Talbot. Tampa Bay has a 3-2 lead over Philadelphia. 8.5 left in the second period. Jordan Staal on Tim Conboy. A loose puck in the Carolina zone. 7:48 left in the second period. Tyler Kennedy's shot fended off by Cam Ward. Ryan Whitney is up in the play. Talbot is there. Kennedy again, defended by Conboy. It pops out. Carolina seizes control, and away they go. Andrew Ladd coming up, moving on the defense of Daryl Sador. Ladd has points in three straight. So does Sergei Samsonov. Samsonov denied ice. Played along the boards here by Tyler Kennedy. He's pestered from behind by Samsonov. Sergei Samsonov going wide. Throwing it to an open area. Bora fanning on it. Samsonov gets it back. His shot is blocked by Jordan Staal. Another chance for Samsonov on the doorstep. Boy, he can take nothing and make it something. Sergei Samsonov again in close with a lot of creativity.
The puck is on a string for him right now. And he's been good from the very beginning, claimed off of waivers. But you really can tell that confidence level has really elevated and the way he handles the puck.
Chances are 7-3 Carolina in this period, 13-5 in the contest. The shots are 25-14 Carolina. 6:43 left to go in the second period. Scott Walker out to center ice with Keith Acoin and Ryan Beta. Beta with a shot. Good save by Savarin. A big rebound. A loose puck as we see. Jarkko Ruutu center zone for big George Larocque. His shot is blocked by Kavrila, brought in by Ruutu. Backchecking Acoin. Jarkko Ruutu from the corner and directly off the boards. Letang this way. It's Orpik who has one of two Pittsburgh goals. Inside, Pauline is there. Played along the boards. Nathan Smith going down, and now it's carried out by Carolina's Keith Acoin. Acoin drops it off for Walker. Walker going wide on the target. Good save by Savarin. Dug out by Walker again. Acoin! Oh, it's blocked in front. Orpik was there. And now it's Larocque through the center ice area. Tim Conboy at the line. Acoin, another chance. Hamilton sneaking in. Tough angle right through the goal mouth. Acoin again off the wall. Inside for Brookbank. Broken up by Letang. Loose in back of the goal. Hustling is Hamilton. Letang going down. Hamilton. But Letowski fanning on it. His stick lifted by Talbot. Conboy. Hamilton. Shooting one. Caught by Savarin. He fumbles it. And then he covers up. Carolina applying pressure late in the second period and showing their character in this 2-2 standoff here at the RBC Center. We're back with more after you watch this on FSN South.
It was against the Tampa Bay Lightning, and it happened January 18th as Crosby slides into the end boards and an ankle injury. And as I said earlier in our telecast, he has begun skating with the team. Actually, he has since late last week. He is on the road here tonight, and what a confidence boost it is for anybody with Pittsburgh that their record, they've won twice as many games as they've lost. And a lot of it has to do with Malkin, guys like Gontcher, their power play, their goaltending's been good, but they've had a great work ethic night in, night out, and they are getting outworked in this hockey game. You have to wonder if you know, the fact that they played last night and fatigue is at all a factor.
And Carolina's will, very strong tonight, Tripp. You get that feeling from between the benches where you're located. 5:15 left in the second period. 2-2 game here in Raleigh. First of two straight at home for the Hurricanes. Hurricanes at home against Florida on Saturday night. No local television, but we'll be with you on President's Day from the rockin' downtown Newark. 12:30 for Hurricanes Live. We can't wait to get back to Newark. With it now out of the corner, it's Walker. He's checked by Ryan Whitney. And now it's played here in the Pittsburgh zone by Colby Armstrong. Center ice area, Chris Beach. Walking in, Cam Ward knocks it down. A big rebound. Pauline is there for the Hurricanes. Armstrong has control. Colby Armstrong delivers a pass and back of the goal. Route 2 is canceled by Pauline, and swooping back is Scott Walker. Out to center ice, Daryl Sador moving it off for Peter Sikora, and he'll dump it in. Under 5 minutes left in the second period as play comes to a halt. And we'll take a look at Sid the Kid during the morning skate here in Raleigh.
Well, they're going to have to really err on the side of caution. I'd be surprised if he comes back before the beginning of March. He was on the ice for a while. I mean, he looks like he's feeling quite good, especially those ankle injuries. Their goaltender Fleury is coming back from one now in the American League for conditioning. You want to make sure, especially when the team's playing like they are, to wait as long as you can.
Nick Vallin over the line, moving up on Malkin. Down low, it's Stahl on Scuderi. Malkin is there too. A four-man scrum. Sabrin, sensing trouble, will cover up and get a face-off in his own end.
And again, the matchup against Malkin is Eric Stahl with Colin Whitney, and Vallin and Whitney on defense. And I wonder if that's why Therrien is making this change right here. I bet it is. He wants to get Malkin away from Stahl and away from the one veteran pairing that is on the Carolina blue line.
Off the faceoff, it comes back in the Carolina end. Vallin pestered by Tyler Kennedy. Kennedy going deep in the zone, holding onto the puck. Moving it off for Talbot. Up top now, it's Gontcher, isolated a bit. A wrister through traffic, knocked down by Vallin. His defense partner, Wesley, now shoves it back for the Swede. It goes by him. And Eric Cole is on the ice, and he braces for a hit thrown at him by Kennedy. Along the boards, Carolina hemmed in. Kennedy digs it out off of Cam Ward. Getting to the top of your screen is Sergei Gontcher. Gontcher off of glass support. Back of the goal, Kennedy again, working hard. Pauline there too, just that logjam of humanity now tied up behind Cam Ward. They want to freeze it, both teams do. Referees say move the puck. It's like a rugby match now. And they'll just hold it there. And common sense says blow the whistle, and they finally do. Come on now. That's ridiculous. Anyway, on another note, nominate an elementary or middle school teacher who shows outstanding leadership in the classroom. 25 teachers win $500 in classroom cash. The grand prize is a $2,000 spree at Stones. Go to rbccentura.com right now.
Watson is actually explaining, Brad Watson, to Michelle Therrien why he waited that long to blow the whistle.
What's the explanation?
If I'm reading his lips correctly, he's saying, if guys are just going to stand there, I'm not going to blow it. If they're moving and the puck doesn't move, then I will blow the whistle. That's what I got of it, as he's talking to Ryan Malone, who is right in the middle of all of it right now.
Well, that's just, again, ridiculous, because if the players are tired, the defensemen are working hard to tie it up, the forecheckers there too, and they tie it up that long, blow it dead, and fresh people on the ice and get on with it.
Sabrin, by the way, tending to an equipment issue of some sort. I'm blocked out by Malone where I'm at, and so we'll have a further delay. Something with his pants, I think. Big faceoff coming up here for Malkin, and with Samsonov and Ladd on the ice, this would be a draw that Rod Brindamore unquestionably will take. So during this prolonged stoppage, boy, Peter Laviolette gets away. No, he doesn't. He tried to bring Stahl's line back on the ice, and Watson would have none of it. Laviolette tried to get away with it. He couldn't.
Good try.
Very good try.
Yep. Watson's a capable referee. He's worked the Stanley Cup Finals. He worked the finals in 06. It's a lot of the big games. It's wristed in front, knocked down by Letowski. Off they come. Andrew Ladd from well out, caught by Sabrin. He'll hang on. They want him to move it. And now he goes for a waltz, and he's going to get a penalty for delay of game. And Brad Watson is taking over. So he now is putting his stamp on this game as the goaltender will get a penalty for not moving the puck.
Wow, I don't know if Sabourin, you don't want to move it just for the sake of doing it if it's going to, you know,
right,
cause a doorstep chance.
Good point.
He's looking around here. He's trying to find someone, but you've got Carolina sliding in first, Ladd, and then Letowski.
Yeah.
I don't know what his options were. I mean, he had every intention to move it. He just didn't have a viable option. So Carolina's power play will look to click for the third time.
Excellent point, Tripp. That's an official without a feel for the game. That, again, is ridiculous. It's cleared off the stick of Ryan Malone. It comes all the way back. So a good break for the Hurricanes. Sabourin, the goaltender, delay at 16:56. Carolina goes to work on the power play. Through the center zone, it's Caberle. Off for Hamilton, he'll wind it in. Danny Sabourin out to play it with the stick this time. Try and move it by Staal. Gonchar races across, sealed off by Caberle. Getting to it, Sergei Gonchar. The veteran clears it all the way down to Cam Ward. 2:30 left to go the second period. Two goals in this period. Carolina getting the tying goal from Eric Staal at 10:36. The Canes have scored two power play goals tonight. Center zone area. The aforementioned Staal gains entry. Hamilton races deep. He'll settle the puck down. Play it up top for Frank Caberle. He's guarded by Colby Armstrong. Rolled over the stick of Eric Staal. Here's Cole. Eric Cole back for Caberle. Now Frank Caberle on the turning stick of Cole. Everything on the outside. Now an isolated chance maybe for Caberle. Wide to a screen. Staal out in front. The Penguins get to it. Out she goes. 50 seconds left on the Hurricane power play.
Product of probably isolating a period. Caberle was not able to settle that puck and get it off to the net as quickly as he wanted to. That was probably the difference between getting it through and eventually not.
In the center ice area now, it's Walker. A lead pass intended for a coin. Cleared ahead by Ryan Whitney. Cam Moore will leave it there on a tee for Caberle. Final push for the Hurricanes. 25 seconds left in this man advantage. Scott Walker from the red line will scale it around the boards. Ladd is there. Wesley at the point. A coin inside for Ladd out of his reach. And getting to it here is Ryan Malone up the gut and out. The Canes are down to 10 seconds as we see. Keep the coin. Nice stick handling. He tries to move it by Malkin. And with it now is Walker. Samsonov with a head of steam. Sergei Samsonov plays it off the boards. Letang is there for the Pens. A coin. Forechecking Ryan Whitney. Serving the penalty was Peter Sikora. He's on the ice. That was for the goaltender. And it comes all the way back. Under a minute left in the middle session. 39-year-old Glenn Wesley logging all kinds of minutes tonight with a depleted Carolina defense and playing extremely well. Wesley from his own territory. Off the boards. The center ice area, it's Beta. All the way across, moving Letowski. Coming up, shooting one. Bodied down by Sabourin. Letowski for Whitney. Whitney has Beta. His shot off the glove hand of Sabourin. The second great scoring chance tonight for Ryan Beta. And now a skirmish in front of Danny Sabourin. Letowski mixing it up. As Letowski, Whitney, and Beta almost make it happen.
That has to be the best save of the game. You're less than 30 seconds to get into the intermission, and it could have been the lead. Whitney double shifting. What a save. That is just a brilliant reflex by the goaltender Sabourin. I think you said earlier, John, that the book is he's got a very good glove. Well, that's a pretty darn good glove right there. What a save.
The big kid, and they have an interesting decision to make when Marc-Andre Fleury comes back. The way Conklin has played, he's been a hero since coming up. Sabourin's been solid. This is his 23rd game of the season, and then Fleury, of course, is the said to be number one. Armstrong, centering one by Cam Ward. Now it's brought out here by Eric Staal with Whitney and Faleen. Over the line, he's in, holding on to it. Faleen off his stick. In deep, 9 seconds left in the period. Wrap chance, Staal denied by Sabourin. Staal again, off the back of the goal. 3 seconds left to go in the period. Cole moving up. Jordan Staal has it. The horn goes here in Raleigh.
The Hurricanes really deserve a better fate than a 2-2 game. 33-15, the edge in shots on goal. The big boys have showed up as we continue to talk about the fact that there is a depleted Carolina lineup. Three defensemen, three rookies playing, and just a great effort through two periods. 2-2 easily could be a couple of goal cushion for the Hurricanes.
Two power play goals in the period. Evgeny Malkin for Pittsburgh. Answered by Eric Staal for the Hurricanes at 10:36. It's the RBC Centura. Second intermission right here on FSN South. We've seen all-star performances tonight by Evgeny Malkin on the left, Eric Staal on the right. Chevrolet has the numbers after 40.
Carolina's power play is 50%. And even though Pittsburgh has a power play goal, we showed in our highlights that the Hurricanes had a couple of great shorthanded chances right before that sort of fluky power play goal. 16-5 in scoring chances. That's better than 3-1.
Yeah. Even where I went to school, way back when. Now comes all the way back in the zone. Sergei Gonchar back to play it for Pittsburgh. John Forslund, Trip Tracy at ice level tonight here on FSN South as we commence this third period. A 2-2 game. Gonchar letting it go back for Rob Scuderi. He'll clear it off the boards. On the gallop here is Peter Sikora moving ahead of Wesley. Ryan Malone in for Sikora. They work a cycle game now. Malone fronted by Vallin. Good defense by Nick Vallin again. And Eric Staal dumps it out. Wesley and Vallin have been stalwarts tonight with a depleted core. Joe Corvo, the newcomer, Tim Gleason, and Brett Hedekin, all three not in the lineup. Carolina losing captain Rod Brindamore with a knee injury early in the first period. Tyler Kennedy in the skates of Jordan Staal. Latowski sends it all the way out. A foot race ensues. Samsonov and playing the angle for Pittsburgh, Daryl Sador. Well, angle one all the way down to Cam Ward. Frank Kaberle back to play it. Deep in his own zone, using the wall, getting it out. Sador, D to D, Ryan Whitney, former first-round draft choice, out to center. Max Talbot gains entry, shoots one, blocked by Tim Conboy. Played ahead by Cam Ward. Kennedy from the wall, floats it inside. Moving here, Jordan Staal on Joey Mormina, making his NHL debut. Coming up is Daryl Sador. Played here by Tyler Kennedy. Ryan Whitney wristing one, blocked in front. Samsonov uses the glass and gets it out.
This has been a great pairing over the last couple of months. Sador, the veteran, with a good young player but already established defenseman in Ryan Whitney. You can see down here from ice level how Whitney's always looking up the ice and looking to make that tape-to-tape pass.
Tim Conboy, seventh-round choice of San Jose back in 02. Moving it off for Joey Mormina. Now it's brought in but overskated by Colby Armstrong. He'll shoot it deep in Carolina ice. Frank Kaberle, Conboy staying out there. Keith LeCoyne swoops back as they work the breakout. Conboy all the way across this way. It's Keith LeCoyne. He's in the zone with Beta, holding on to it. Shot on the target. Good save by Sabourin. And it deflects in the mesh. We go back to the Rat Pack tonight. And we're talking about the Albany River Rat Pack. Here it is.
How about that pass that Conboy just made? Speaking of tape to tape, up the ice. And all of these guys are really doing a great job of distinguishing themselves. Joey Mormina playing in his first NHL game. He should have had a goal pinching in the second period. It just goes to show that there's great parity in the league, and there's not that big of a difference between the NHL and the American Hockey League, as these guys have done a beautiful job. A lot of them traveling today on short notice.
Kaberle drops it off, a coin now. Native of Waltham, Massachusetts. Inside it goes. Nathan Smith is canceled at the D by Casey Bohr. Here's Chris Letang for George Larocque. Larocque lays the body on Kaberle, forgets the puck, and it's cleared ahead by Scott Walker. Brooks Orpik has one of two Pittsburgh goals tonight. Malkin has the other. Carolina getting goals from Eric Cole and Eric Staal. 3 minutes gone in this third period, deadlocked at two. Orpik in the zone, and Carolina in a three-way tie atop the southeast. Cam Ward, a stand-up save on Orpik. Malkin shot turned out by Cam Ward. And a penalty will be called on Eric Staal down low. He tied up Maxime Talbot. And it's possibly Talbot for holding the stick. He's the one protesting. Carolina will be getting a power play.
That's exactly what's happening. Wow. What a potential turn of events. Terry won't like that one bit. Brooks Orpik actually had made a great rush up the ice, throwing the puck on the net, and caused a real battle in front. Then Talbot takes the penalty shortly thereafter. Orpik's had a good hockey game. I know he's public enemy number one, but he's played well. Wesley batting that puck out, and then the hold on the stick from Talbot right afterwards.
Fifth power play trip for Carolina. They are 50% tonight. 2-for-4 as it's cleared all the way back. It's been a simple night of getting the puck at the net and cashing in. As we pointed out earlier, Carolina 0-for-18 in the last five of the power play. He worked on it this morning. Stahl shot deflects wide off the stick of Gonchar. Hamilton back to the point. Whitney. Here's Cavalla holding onto it. Frank Cavalla now wheeling his stall. Whitney sneaks in, holding, scoring! What a goal! Ray Whitney! Another power play goal. Carolina by one.
Boy, that was a thing of beauty. And now Ray Whitney has been instrumental in all three Carolina goals. All three. And Talbot comes back as he banged the door a couple times in the first period. Now he almost hits me with his stick in disgust. He knows an offensive zone penalty leads to that. Look at that traffic from Cole that prevented the goaltender from even following this puck. Stahl, a nice feed. And Cole has Scuderi leave him to try to play the puck. And because of Eric Cole taking Scuderi, the goaltender never even saw that. Never even saw that. So the power play's established a shot tonight. And they've had constant movement. Those are two very important ingredients.
22nd goal of the season. Ray Whitney, Malkin, dropping it back for Sikora. His shot fended off by Cam Ward. Glenn Wesley given a jolt by Evgeny Malkin. Ryan Malone, Malkin run into by Stahl. They engage. A big war along the boards between Malkin and Stahl. And it's skated out by Ray Whitney. Fended off again by Danny Sabrin. The assists, Eric Stahl, Frank Cavalla. 3:45 the time, Carolina's third power play goal tonight. Orpik run into by Letowski. Whitney, Ryan Whitney telegraphed it. Samsonov, shooting one, and Sabrin hangs on.
And hangs on is the key phrase, because he did not know that he got that. That could have been just an electrifying goal. He just brought his arm on the blocker side into the body, and he looked behind him, which tells you that a goaltender does not know if he got it. Watch him look behind him. Oh, he's just hoping that he squeezed it enough. That's a big save. Great anticipation from Sergei Samsonov. Good place to shoot.
Boy, it may have kicked off Orpik's stick and ricocheted up to Sabrin. Samsonov with a scoring chance. Pittsburgh is down a man. Jeff Tafe, broken nose, will not be back. Just about 5 minutes gone in this third period. Down low it goes. Along the boards now. Holding onto it here is Chris Beach. All the way across for Orpik. His spinner knocked down by Jarkko Ruutu. Scott Walker off the boards, not out. Ward out to play it. Cam Ward leaving it there in open ice for Tim Conboy, who clears it ahead. On the wing, it's Ryan Beta, defended by Pittsburgh's Chris Letang. Letang now back in his own zone. Carolina getting the go-ahead goal from Ray Whitney at 3:45. What has been a very good hockey game tonight. It's rolled in wide of Cam Ward. Jordan Stahl going to work. Cavalla right there. Along the boards, it's Talbot again. Talbot in deep for Tyler Kennedy. Kennedy in back of the goal has Jordan Stahl out in front. Kennedy holding onto it. Looks to thread the needle. Continues to hold it. Now he's hurried. And a good play by Casey Bohr. Heading to it now, Andrew Lapp. Can he clear? No. Sador keeps the zone. He'll move it deep. Along the boards this way, a Pittsburgh player going down. That was Kennedy. Play will continue as Daryl Sador mops it up.
When Kennedy had that puck behind that, couldn't find anybody. That tells you how good the coverage was.
Here's Stahl. Jordan Stahl shot handled by Cam Ward. Casey Bohr, smart choice, off the wall and out. Just over 6 minutes gone in the third period. Coughed up situation, Malkin dangling, walking, and it's tipped out of play by Casey Bohr. A good defensive play on Evgeny Malkin. The Wizard coming through. Everybody loves Raymond. 3-2, Carolina.
I can tell you that the guy on the right stall does not talk a lot of smack, but as we were going to commercial, he just said, nice play, Max. Good play. His stall just getting on the ice. Just elbowed Eric Stahl, that consecutive games played streak intact. Of course, it's Talbot that takes the offensive zone penalty that leads to the go-ahead goal. And Malkin, even getting off the ice a minute ago, John, was talking to the Carolina bench. I didn't know he had that in his repertoire. It tells you that Carolina, with their work, is frustrating the Pittsburgh Penguins.
That's right. If they're not saying anything, they're in control. And that's, again, a perception you get from where you're at tonight. Good job. There to play it is Stahl. Moving off. Where he's at, if you're joining us, is right smack between the two benches. Now it's brought in here by Malkin. Malkin with Sikora. Short sider shut down by Cam Ward. Malkin again. Evgeny Malkin back to the point. Gonchar. Malkin now mishandling the puck, getting it back from Sikora, walking it. Right in the slot, a shot blocked by Vallin. So Nick Baleen gets in the way, and Carolina survives again. They get it out. Just about 7 minutes gone in this third period. 3-2 Hurricanes. Whitney, the go-ahead goal in period three. Gonchar centers one. It's covered up by Cam Ward. And they get a face-off. Our next telecast will come your way Monday, President's Day, from The Rock in Newark, as the Canes look for revenge against New Jersey. The Devils and the Hurricanes, 12:30. For Hurricanes Live, the face-off shortly after 1 p.m. right here on FSN South.
That was Malkin's best shift of the hockey game. And he had a great chance, and yeah, Pauline gets a piece of it in front of Ward. But that was Malkin's best work of the night.
Orpik at the point. Armstrong for Beach. It's Beach, LaRock, and Armstrong for Michael Therrien. Letang feathering away from Ryan Beta. A coin. Walker and Beta for Peter Laviolette. Fighting off a man and doing it well is Keith Acoin. Ryan Beta feeds it deep. It's Letang's corner. Letang back to play, and around the boards it goes. Reading the play, Comboy. A wild pass out in front. Walker traps the zone. Letang was knocked down. He didn't see the puck. And Armstrong, it's finished off by Walker. Chipped ahead by Ryan Beta. He'll peel off in a change. 12:20 left to go in this third period. Brooks Orpik now hears it from the crowd. It's brought in the zone by Letowski. Letowski holding. Tough angle. Sabourin says no and hangs on.
And as he hears it from the crowd, this crowd has filled in quite nicely. Good job there with Letowski. Make sure you get a shot. Maybe if he were to do it again, he'd try to keep it low and shoot for that far side, because then one of the guys going to the net would be able to get a crack at it.
Faceoff, Trevor Letowski this time with Jordan Staal. Letowski, Samsonov, and Ladd. Kaberla and Casey Bohr on the points. Faceoff win by the Pens. Ryan Whitney turns it over. Pressure by Samsonov. The puck gained by Ladd. Samsonov again has Letowski out in front. They wedge one. It's loose, as you see. Casey Bohr keeps it deep. Bohr again at the point. Turning his Ladd. Holding onto it. Andrew Ladd moving it off of Sergei Samsonov. This way for Trevor Letowski. Negated briefly by Ryan Whitney. Now you're looking at Tyler Kennedy. In neutral ice, it's Kaberla. Samsonov again. He can stick handle in a phone booth. He goes wide. Good pull up away from Sidor. Creating space for himself. He shoots one. Locked in front by Jordan Staal. And it comes back out to neutral ice.
He does a good job of trying to involve the defense coming into the play too, as Sergei just gets off the ice now. He couldn't there because the lane was covered, but he did it as recently as Boston, finding Kaberla eventually for his game-winning goal.
Cole seals it off. He moves it by Nathan Smith. Gonchar, D-to-D, Rob Scuderi. Scuderi now feeds it in. Cam Ward slows it up a bit. Loose along the boards. Nathan Smith back to the point. Slow pass. And a good opportunity for Acoin to dive ahead. Along the boards now, Acoin working hard. And Ryan Beta will angle it off the wall and get it out. Approaching the halfway mark in this third period, a one-goal game. The lead, Carolina, as you see. Center zone, it's Ruutu. Ruutu pestered from behind by Walker. Now it's mopped up by Wesley. He's checked by Nathan Smith. Armstrong says hello to Walker. Moving back, Casey Bohr. Bohr ahead now for Ryan Beta, and again out to center ice, where Acoin pokes it in. Rob Scuderi on the wing for Jarkko Ruutu. Pittsburgh is changing on the fly. Ruutu holding onto it. They clear it deep for the Pens, and getting to it now, Casey Bohr batting it down with a high stick. And we get a stoppage here. The subject of Casey Bohr. Let's see his first NHL goal.
It was a huge goal. A come from behind victory over the Atlanta Thrashers. Just a quick release. I believe it was on a power play. I can't tell you for sure. Either way, an assist in that game too. A huge come from behind win against the Atlanta Thrashers. And he was also used in the last minute of that hockey game, protecting a one-goal lead.
And these reinforcements traveled all day today. They got in very late. They got in around 5 o'clock tonight at RDU and shuttled across to make it to the locker room, put on the gear, and play. And they've done well. Staal moving it off now for Cole. Cole coming up on Orpik. His shot denied by Sabourin. Loose change out in front. And the Penguins get to it. Sakura. Evgeny Malkin. Malkin coming up on Wesley. Wide open Malone. He tries to return the favor. He gets it back. Ryan Malone. Chris Letang now loading the gun. Moving across, but it's picked off. One pass too many. Hitting to it is Eric Cole. Has a goal tonight. Shifting on Letang. He addresses Letang and almost walks in. Cole swings it across. Picked off by Max Talbot. He'll wind it up.
Great move there from Cole. And prior to that, Nick Pauline makes another key block. He's had two big ones here in the third period.
Tyler Kennedy on Frank Cabrera. Floating one. Stick save by Ward. Getting to it. Kennedy again. Kennedy walks. His shot off the mesh. And they get a stoppage. 9:21 left in regulation time. Cole working hard all night long. And the Canes have a one-goal lead.
Well, we're back here, Andrew. A real, real solid hockey game. Three power play goals. You've gone to the front of the net. What have you liked most about the power play here tonight?
I think just the fact that we're getting pucks in net and keeping it simple and creating a little traffic in front.
What, with Rod Brind'Amour going down, tell us what the bench was like right then and why you guys have been able to recover so nicely without your captain.
Well, he's obviously a big part of our team and the heart and soul. But this time of the year when you guys stepping up, and I thought we've had a lot of energy tonight. Guys have stepped up all over the place.
There's no doubt about it. 9:14 left in this third period. A one-goal game in KC Boer. Young defenseman recalled today will settle it down. Talbot cut it off for Pittsburgh. Boer takes a hit, throws it around the board. Samsonov is on the ice. He has control. He's peppered by Jordan Staal. A loose puck, and Samsonov goes to work. Cut off at the line momentarily by Talbot. It goes by Samsonov, and the Penguins restart. 8:45 left in this third period. John Forslund, Trip Tracy with you, FSN South. The Canes are home against Florida in the Southeast Division matchup on Saturday night. As you see, the shots on goal, 40 for the Hurricanes, 20 by the Pittsburgh Penguins. Around the boards now, Walker awaiting that puck. Through the center ice area, he negotiates by Malkin, throws it off for Bata. His shot, scores! Hey, hey, what do you say? Ryan Bata, Carolina, by a deuce.
Oh, what a goal. What a goal off the rush. And Bata has been stymied a few times since being recalled before Tuesday's game by Alex Aull to the Bruins, and earlier in this one, a first period chance by Danny Sabourin, but this was not going to be stopped by anybody, and he's got his first of the year. Just perfect work up the ice. As you see, Malkin gets caught. You have two players. That creates the three-on-two, and a coin goes to the front of the net, and this is just an absolute precision shot. Scott Walker told us after the first period, he loves playing with these two guys, Acoin and Bata, because they work so, so hard. And there you can see the finish that Bata has long had at the American League level, and a huge goal. They're a beautiful transitional play.
Ryan Bata, his first goal this season. 11:39 the time. Carolina by two. In deep. Scott Walker getting an assist on that goal. And I believe Glenn Wesley will get an assist too. 7:45 left to go. Regulation time. Around the boards again. Staal after it. Eric Staal will scoop the puck through the center zone. Knocked down out of midair by Ryan Malone. Play is whistled dead.
I've never seen Evgeny Malkin. He's slapping his stick on the bench right now. I've never seen him this frustrated in his young career.
Stay tuned following our game tonight for Hurricanes Live postgame news, updates, and analysis of this action tonight, which has been great. Hurricanes Live before and after every Canes game on FSN Sound.
Malkin still jabbing at the official right now. Boy, he still is. He's talking to Furlot. They're still talking. Furlot saying, you better button those lips, otherwise you're going to get a penalty. He gave him quite a bit of rope, but that just goes to show you're doing your job if you're Carolina when you frustrate as hot of a player as there is in the league right now.
21 years old, and you know, Trip, this game will humble anybody at any time, even veteran players, but it's a lesson tonight if it continues for Malkin. You have to just put it aside. And it seems like he's been distracted tonight. That's good. Jarkko Ruutu going down, a high stick. And a penalty is being called up top by Brad Watson with 7:07 left to go in this third period. Pittsburgh now will get a power play.
He's not cut. He just skated right in front of me. There's a scrape below his right eye. Looks like it maybe was a scar that he already had. So it's only going to be 2 minutes, I believe. Ryan Bata, who's just scored the goal, will get the penalty. And just waiting to see that two goes up on the board. Right here at the neutral zone. A good look from our truck. And so Pittsburgh will try to cling to this power play to get back into the hockey game.
2-minute minor for high sticking. Ryan Beta, 12:53. 1-for-3, the Penguins are on the power play. See the numbers, the shot totals. Out of the corner, Pauline. The scrum, Ryan Malone, Sikora, Malkin going down again. Stahl and Whitney killing it off the front. Wesley and Pauline are back. Stahl throws on the brakes. They'll try to move it deep and kill time. Ryan Malone all the way across, and he spots Ryan Whitney. Whitney over the line in the zone, moving up. Sikora encumbered by the pass, defended by Wesley. Stahl lays it ahead for Whitney. Ray Whitney in the zone, moving up now on the D. In the circle, cradling that puck, and again, killing more time. And the Penguins have squandered all but the first minute here of this power play. 6:15 left in regulation time. Quarterbacking out, top scoring defenseman Sergei Gonchar. Malkin off the stick of Whitney. Petowski after it, so is Young Bohr. It's held in by Ryan Malone. Along the boards now, battle here. Sikora taking down Scott Walker. Malkin tries to win it free from Bohr. Now playing in the skate is Ryan Malone. Walker getting back. Good job by Scott Walker. The open man is Frank Kamerla, and out she goes.
Well, that's just a super job. Heads up play by Scott Walker. You can just see him getting off the ice right now. He's, you know, experiencing all sorts of pain. Still makes the good composed play.
Back of the goal, it's Cam Ward, leaving it there for Nick Vallin. It goes by Letang. It's a foot race. Cole. Nobody's going to stop 26. Here he is, and Severin got a piece of it. Right out of a cannon, Eric Cole. Now it's Letang. Out to center ice. Wing it on the wing. Beach is there. He'll try and move it by Cole. He does. Wesley, what a hit! Oh, mercy! What a hit on Beach! And Jordan Stahl takes a run at Glenn Wesley.
And he may get a penalty for it. Boy, Chris Beach has been traveling from one team to the next. Columbus, Vancouver, Washington, all over the map. And wow, did he ever not enjoy it. Travels to Raleigh on that particular play. Let's look at Cole's chance first. The roof would have come down had he scored here. And is Wesley going to get a penalty?
It's unbelievable if it's... Wow.
They're going to... The puck's right there.
It is.
There's nothing interference in any slight. Well,
nope.
Jordan Stahl's going to get one, too. That's surprising. That looked to be as clean of a hit as you're going to find, as Wesley has just enjoyed a banner night. Again, with Gleason, Hedekin, and Corvo out of the lineup. Has he ever elevated his game?
I'll tell you what. That's a confusing play, isn't it, Tripp? I mean, we see that play too, where the puck is there. Sometimes they'll allow a battle. They'll allow this. But here, because Beach was not able to play the puck, I believe it'll be interference on Wesley, and then Stahl coming in for the retribution.
I call that a battle for sure. I mean, I'm surprised at that one. I mean, that's one of those plays that makes hockey great. The many thousands in attendance here certainly enjoyed every bit of it. So just 5 seconds left in the penalty. It's just about to elapse to Ryan Beta.
Five on four scenario. Off the faceoff now. Borer will hammer it up the wall. Malkin digs it out. Centers across. Bouncing puck. Eric Stahl out to center. Eric Stahl hammering one and Severin. They'll shovel it off. He covers, and we get a whistle. We're going down the stretch at the RBC Center. Wesley says hello to Chris Beach.
Well, it was just a couple weeks ago in Pittsburgh that Carolina had a 1-0 lead entering the third period, and the Penguins had a torrid comeback. Well, tonight, the dominating third period team has been Carolina. First Whitney and then Beta for a 2-goal lead. And Eric Cole just had a breakaway a few minutes ago. And I just asked Cole, if you take a look at the game summary. And Eric Cole just said to me, he said, I said, did you get a piece of it? He said, using nicknames that he used, Wardo said it hit his stick. And I said, Wardo, from where he's at, how could he tell? He's at the other end.
A penalty trip for tripping. Right off the faceoff, Eric Furlong will give us the call, and he does. And Evgeny Malkin will take a seat.
That just goes to show how incredibly frustrated Evgeny Malkin is in this hockey game. Carolina has completely taken him off of his game, and that's just as symbolic of getting outworked that he takes the legs from underneath Eric Staal. I mean, you as shining of a star as this guy is, you cannot take that penalty, a lazy penalty, if you will, when you're down two goals this late in a hockey game.
Power play for Carolina. Whitney taken down. That could have been a call. We put the whistle away on that one. Carolina 3 for 5 tonight with 8 shots, as you see, on the power play. Late stages of period 3. Undermanned, but coming up big in terms of heart tonight. The 4-2 lead in this third period. Staal all the way across. Borah holding off of Scuderi, getting it back. Casey Borah. He finds Ray Whitney. Whitney to the point man. Carroll, don't think about it. Whitney from the wall. Looking for a lane, now thinking pass. Threading across, a bouncing puck. Rob Scuderi plays it off the boards, back out to neutral ice. Just about 16 minutes gone in this third period. Ray Whitney for Eric Cole. Cole, Whitney again. Whitney holding on to it. He'll move it indirectly off the boards. Nicky Pauline at the point. Turning back is Whitney. Flushed out by Talbot all the way across. Pauline for Kaberle. Now it's Staal again. Whitney! Connect the dots! And one pass too many would have been beautiful. Whitney had a chance, but unselfishly gave it away. Now Stahl's chance. Stop! And they score! But they wave it off. Interference. Eric Cole on Danny Sabourin, I believe. They wave off the goal.
And it doesn't look like they're going to call a penalty. You have that option here of just waving it off or waving it off and calling a penalty. It looks like they'll just wave it. Let's watch here. Well, that's a tough one. It's within the crease. Ray Whitney's actually over here looking at our monitor. I don't know, Ray. He doesn't like it.
Well, the thing is, Cole stopped, and there was very little contact. Watch.
Yeah,
it's
incidental within the crease area. So now Staal's looking. What do you think, Eric? You don't want to get yourself in trouble. Can you show it to us one more time, Eric Barnhart, our producer? Staal would like to take a look.
Classic moment here.
And Whitney, they're all taking a look down here. Eric, there you go. Tell me what you think. I don't know. I pretty incidental.
There's not much Cole can do. I mean, there was contact.
Well, that's classic. Yeah, I mean, we've got these guys down here looking at the replay with us.
Okay.
You know, now Ray's back over here now. And
this is classic. Look at this.
What I equate it to is the goal that was disallowed from Nick Lindstrom against Anaheim. Holmstrom, similar type play. Even when it's incidental within that blue shaded crease, was the goaltender Sabourin prevented from doing his job? I guess that would be the explanation from the official.
Staal throws it across. Bohr moving in. 39 seconds in the power play. Here's Kaberle. Casey Bohr, shot taken, absorbed by Danny Sabourin. He'll get another faceoff.
That's true interactive television, I'd have to say. We've got the players coming over. You look at Carolina's third period goals, and you know, they've had the Penguins come from behind and beat them twice in this season, so that would make this extra gratifying to have this kind of third.
Walker moving it in deep. Back to the point it goes. Kaberle, one-timer. Four! Big stop by Sabourin. Paying the price out in front was Scott Walker. It's cleared all the way back down. 14 seconds left on the penalty to Evgeny Malkin. Under 3 left in this third period. A 2-goal lead by the Canes. A corner. Walker has a chance. Sabourin says no. And he squeezes those pads together.
And one of Carolina's calling cards when they're playing well and in this building is they don't look to just win the game 4-2. Aside from the disallowed goal, they've had 2 or 3 golden opportunities to make this 5-2. And with the guys that are out of the lineup, Eric, Cole, and Staal, and Whitney needed to show up. Those are the guys that haven't been producing offensively of late, and boy, have they ever. All of them in multiple fashion here in this hockey game, an inspiring effort on home ice.
3 defensemen out with a variety of injuries, 2 with the flu. Corvo and Gleason. Hennekin out with a lower body problem. And then you also have a situation tonight where Carolina loses captain Rod Brind'Amour. with a knee injury early and has played virtually the entire game without him. 2:25 left to go in this third period. Moved on the wing by Whitney, intended for Cole. And getting back on it here is Brooks Orpik. This is the final game of the season series between these two teams. And it's cleared ahead as Malkin had a chance at it. Orpik now backpedaling. He'll clear it off the boards. 2:04 left in this third period. We'll keep an eye on Danny Sabourin and see when Michael Therrien takes a gamble. Samsonov on Gonchar. And Gonchar clears it ahead. Talbot is after it. A good recovery by Casey Bohr. Talbot again winds it in front off of Kennedy. Kennedy wildly by Ryan Whitney. And now Samsonov again pulls up. Sergei Samsonov, he'll make sure he gains center. He takes a hit, but he dumps it deep. 1:39 left in regulation time. Walked out by Sergei Gonchar. Away from Eric Staal, played off the boards. Ward directing traffic, putting on the brakes, Nick Baleen. Along the dash, Cole after it. Getting to it, Ryan Malone. Malone will keep it deep. Tim Conboy's on the ice. He tries to clear, not out. Played ahead by Gonchar, in deep. Back of the goal, Malone is muscled by Valin. They continue that scrum, 70 seconds left to go, and a penalty is being called. Boarding penalty on Nicholas Valin.
I am surprised that Michel Therrien, down not one but two goals, has waited this long. You hear the referee making the call, and now Carolina will be able to ice the puck for free. Let's watch the right hand of Nick Vallin. There he is with Malone. Sure, a timeout will be called by one of the coaches here. I'm shocked that Therrien, down two goals, has not pulled his goaltender. I mean, it's a different ball of wax when you got to get two, and I'm not even sure he's going to pull him now.
Okay, my apologies. It was a holding penalty. We'll take a look at Eastern Conference standings now. And Tampa Bay did win their hockey game tonight against Philadelphia. They have 56 points now. Carolina checking in with 60. Pittsburgh closing in on Ottawa. Tough week for the Senators. They were blasted at home by Buffalo 5-1, losing in overtime last night at New Jersey.
Well, this is going to be interesting here. The biggest players have just had a whale of a hockey game for the Carolina Hurricanes. Staal, Cole, Whitney. It needed to happen going in. And then when you lose Brind'Amour, who's playing on what has been the most effective line with Samsonov and Ladd, it just had to happen, and it certainly has. And the power play's been the biggest catalyst. Now Pittsburgh will, long last, let their goaltender.
Sabourin out. Power play, 6-on-4 scenario. 65 seconds left along the boards now. Sergei Gonchar spinning one. Cam Ward picks it off. Another face-off in the Carolina zone.
Well, Ward has just had to be routine in this hockey game. I mean routine. If anything, he'll look back and say, I'd like to have the Orpik goal in the first period. You thought he'd have to stand on his head with what the lineup is to win this hockey game. That's how good everybody's been in front of him.
Malkin. The face-off win. Getting it back now for Gonchar. A bouncer right in on Ward. The rebound. Cam Ward says no. Loose in front. Poked over the top of the goal. Sikora. Now looking for Jordan Staal out in front. Here's Malkin from the wall. Gonchar will settle it down. You see the time in a 6-on-4. It's centered. Good job by Wesley going down. Sikora in back of the net. Fanning on a pass. Getting it back. Shoveling off of the wing now for Ryan Whitney. Whitney holding on to it. This way goes off a stick. Good sticks by Eric Staal and Ray Whitney. 29 seconds left. Malkin will get it deep by Cam Ward. This way, Ryan Malone. Jordan Staal, his shot off of Malkin. Out of the corner, Malone out in front, intended for Sikora. Good break for Carolina as it comes all the way back. 13 seconds left in regulation time. Malkin looking for it, swatting at it. Wesley for the vacant goal. Chest wide. 6 seconds left. Gonchar is back. And the Carolina Hurricanes dig down and defeat the Pittsburgh Penguins by a margin of 4-2.
Boy, did they ever dig. What a huge hockey game, a huge third period. And this crowd has to, as is indicated in the noise in here right now, appreciate the work ethic that they got tonight. It tells you something about the parity that is in this league, and it tells you about how good Carolina can be when the top players play the kind of hockey that they need to play. Whitney was one of them, Staal was another one, Cole was another, and the work of veteran defensemen like Wesley, Vallin, and the young guys that came up, just a great team effort.
Great team effort in front of Cam Ward. The Carolina Hurricanes 4, the Pittsburgh Penguins 2. Hurricanes live post game on the other side from the RBC Center.